Hi, my name is Valerie and I studied abroad at Kyoto University. Although I studied abroad at Kyoto University around 2018, I've been recently uploading videos because I just graduated from the University of Texas at Austin and I finally have enough time to edit all the videos that I filmed on exchange. And I've been receiving a lot of questions about how I was able to study abroad, what did I do to be able to study at Kyoto University, and I just wanted to address those questions in this video. Before I continue on to my story about how I was able to study abroad and everything, I just want to clarify that I did the QNET program. So there's two types of exchanges at Kyoto University. There's the general exchange and then there's the Kyoto University International Exchange Program, which is the one that I did. So my experiences as to how I was able to get into the program and into the university will be different than my international friends, perhaps different from you. So just wanted to let y'all know, just to keep that in mind as I continue on with my story. As I mentioned before, my home university is the University of Texas at Austin. They're one of the many partners that Kyoto University works with to exchange students for either a whole semester or a whole year. So why Kyoto University? Actually, I wanted to study abroad at Sophia University located in Tokyo, and I was really attracted to what Sophia University had, and it was pretty much a very strong international exchange type school, foreign school. When I made an appointment with my study abroad coordinator/advisor, she asked me a lot about my interest, and I told her my interest in Japan and everything and what I wanted from the whole exchange. She highly suggested that I studied abroad at Kyoto University, which honestly I knew nothing about. I was like, what is Kyoto University? I was like, where is Kyoto? She was like, do some research on it and let me know what you think about it. I did some research about Kyoto University and I fell in love. Kyoto is the old capital of Japan and it has a lot of tradition embedded in it. And honestly, that like just fit my vibe a whole lot more than Tokyo. The other biggest reason that I chose Kyoto University is because Kyoto University is one of the highest ranked universities in Japan. Everyone knows about Tokyo University or Todai. Neck and neck in a lot of areas, Kyoto University or Kyodai is like up there with Todai. Kyodai is also a really, really good research university institution. The third biggest reason was because I wanted to expand my Japanese capabilities, my speaking, my listening, everything. Based off my friends and my advisors, they all said that it was a little bit more difficult to really practice and immerse yourself in full Japanese, just because in Tokyo, you know, there's a lot more foreigners there, and a lot of the times Japanese people who live in Tokyo, they can speak a greater amount of English. The application process, let me break it down for you in a timeline. I knew I wanted to study abroad in Japan my first semester of college. It was probably around October, November. I was scrolling around the study abroad page for UT, and I knew about study abroad because all of my band friends were like, hey, you really need to study abroad. That was one of my biggest regrets, was not being able to study abroad. You need to study abroad. And I was like, okay, I'll study abroad. And I was just looking at like whatever programs. I didn't really think that they would have like any Japanese universities. I clicked on the page, I looked at the countries, found Japan, and I was like, oh my god. Once I found that, I looked at the requirements and I saw that one of the biggest requirements is that you have to have the 610D, or that's the second semester of Japanese, under your course load already by the time you apply. And I was like, oh snap, I already wasted one semester. How am I supposed to study abroad now? And I also didn't want to miss out on band because, you know, marching band mainly happens in the fall semester. And so I was like, okay, I won't study abroad next spring, but I'll study abroad the spring after that, so spring 2018. So then I started my whole plan as to how I would be able to go study abroad. At that time, you know, I didn't know what program. I just knew that I wanted to study abroad in Japan. All of the programs at the time had the 610D requirement, so I knew that I needed two semesters of Japanese under my belt. So spring 2017 came, I took the first semester of Japanese. Around April, I signed up for the second semester of Japanese, and that's when I also started re-looking at the application process. Between August and September 2017, that's when I made my first appointment with the study abroad advisor for Japan. That's where she told me, hey, consider Kyoto University. But regardless, any program that I wanted to go to in Japan, I still needed to fill out essentially the same kind of things. So I needed two references, I needed a resume, I needed two essays, I needed to meet the requirement for the language, which was the 2 semesters of Japanese. I needed to have a 3.5 GPA. Then I also needed to pay a $75 non-refundable fee. So for my references, I thought, okay, I need 2 references. I can ask my first Japanese sensei for the first reference, and then my second Japanese sensei for the second reference. I know other people, what they did was they had other professors who they really knew really well, and they knew their work ethic and everything, and so they asked their professors. And then for the essays weren't that bad. I believe they were like a page or a page and a half each, double spaced, and they have like a few topics that you could choose from. For my resume, I put that I was a member of the Filipino Student Association, I was a member of the Japanese Student Association. I did look at the application stuff that they're requiring right now, and they lowered the GPA requirement for Kyoto University to a minimum of 3.0. So I finished my essays, my resume, got my 2 senses to fill in the references all before the last week of September, because the deadline was October 1st, I believe, for the spring semester. And around November was when the advisor sent our applications to Kyoto University, where they reviewed all of our applications to see if we were qualified. Basically, if you were accepted into the program from UT, you were guaranteed to be accepted from Kyoto University, but they just needed to verify everything just to make sure everything's like within the requirements. That was about end of November, I believe, when Kyoto University got back to us about whether or not we were officially accepted within their university. And after that, and that's when I started, yeah, preparing financially for exchange. My tips and tricks for those who are applying from UT to study abroad at Kyoto University. This may apply to other universities, I can't say.
Hello, this is editing Valerie jumping in the video because I just didn't like the tip that I gave originally and I would like to modify it. The biggest tip that I can give, especially for people who are applying for study abroads that happen in the spring semester, is to stay on top of your application. Deadlines are either the first week of October or the middle of October. Time flies by fast. You want to give yourself ample amount of time to get everything done, especially with your references. There's no professor that's going to be okay with you asking the day before. I mean, maybe there are some if you're like really close with some professors, but most professors, they're going to be like, why didn't you ask me at least 2 weeks in advance? And in essence, yes, you could probably complete your resume and your essays in a day, but do you want to do that to yourself? No.
My second biggest tip is try to adjust your resume and everything to your program. My third biggest tip and trick would be really communicate a lot with your study abroad advisor, whoever they may be, just so that way they can get a feel as to who you are. They can also really help you find a program that would suit you best. Like, see, I wouldn't have gone to Kyoto University had my advisor not suggested Kyoto University to me. Really just communicate with your advisor. I mean, like, don't like send them 5 emails every day, you know, don't do that. Send them an email like once a week, being like, hey, like, I'm still interested in the program, like, what should I do, do you have any advice? Set up virtual meetings, I guess, now in a pandemic. Talk with them for an hour, 30 minutes, however much you need. Know what you want and be honest with yourself. So I hope that answers most of y'all's questions. If I didn't answer a question that you guys had, please let me know in the comments below. I will be answering everything, and if there's a lot of the same questions, I'll probably address that in another video. Thank y'all for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.